We can determine escape velocity value by using law of conservation of energy as follows. So here we are going to determine the escape velocity that a spacecraft will need in order to overcome the Earth's gravitational force. And we are going to determine the escape velocity with the help of law of conservation of energy. An object going vertically upwards from the surface of the Earth, having an initial velocity equal to escape velocity, escapes the gravitational force of the Earth. So, an object will be able to escape from the Earth's gravitational force only if its initial velocity is equal to the escape velocity. The force of gravity being inversely proportional to the square of the distance becomes zero only at infinite distance from the Earth. So we have studied this when we were studying the Newton's universal law of gravitation, that F is inversely proportional to 1 upon d square. So this is what we had studied. So the force of gravity will become zero only at infinite distance from the Earth. This means that for the object to be free from the gravity of Earth, it has to reach infinite distance from the Earth. That is, the object will come to rest at infinite distance and will stay there. So, for an object to be free from the gravity of the Earth, it has to achieve a height that is at infinite distance, because only there we will find that the force of gravity will not act on the object and it will be at rest. So let us calculate it. For an object of mass m on the surface of the Earth, when the object is on the surface of the Earth, kinetic energy is equal to 1 upon 2 mv square or half mv square. Potential energy, we had studied gmm upon R. Here we are not taking plus H as we had in the equation earlier when we were studying the gravitational potential energy, because the object is on the surface of the Earth. So height is going to be zero. Therefore we write gmm upon R, capital M mass of Earth, small m mass of object, and capital R radius of the Earth. But we use a negative sign. Total energy will be equal to E1 is equal to kinetic energy plus the potential energy. And so we get half mv square escape velocity. Here we have written v escape. So this is escape velocity minus gmm upon r. So this is E1. At infinite distance from the Earth. Now the object has reached a height that is infinite distance from the Earth where there is no gravitational force. There the kinetic energy will be zero because the object will come to rest. Since the object will come to rest, kinetic energy will be zero. Potential energy gmm upon infinity. The distance here is at infinity and this will also be zero. Total energy E2 will be kinetic energy plus the potential energy. So both are zero and hence we will get the total energy E2 to be zero. I hope you have got this part of the calculation. At infinite distance from the Earth, kinetic energy is zero because at infinite distance the object has come to rest. Since the object has come to rest, we find that the kinetic energy becomes zero. Similarly, potential energy for an object at infinite distance is also zero because the value of g becomes zero and hence we find that the potential energy is also zero. So total energy, that is E2, kinetic plus potential, becomes zero. From the principle of conservation of energy, E1 is equal to E2. That is, the energy that is possessed by the object on Earth should be equal to the energy that is possessed by the object at infinity. So we substitute the values here. This is E1 and this is E2. Now the remaining steps have been shown here in detail. 1/2 mv square escape is equal to gmm upon r. So we have shifted this minus gmm upon r to this side, so it becomes gmm upon r. mv square is equal to 2 gmm upon r. Now this 2 has been taken to the numerator. V square is equal to 2 gm upon r. From here the mass of the object will get cancelled from both the sides. Now this is what we know. G is equal to gm upon r square. Gm we will keep on one side and we get gr square. So gm is equal to gr square from here. Again going back to this equation, V escape square we have removed. So this side we will put into square root 2gm upon r. 2gm upon r. So V escape is equal to 2gr square upon r. Here we have substituted the value of gm from here. Gm is equal to gr square. So here this is 2. Instead of gm we will write gr square upon r. So 1 r from here and 1 r from here gets cancelled. And so we get is escape velocity is equal to under root 2gr. Escape velocity will be equal to, now we will substitute the values, 2 into 9.8, that is acceleration due to gravity, multiplied by radius of the earth, 6.4 into 10 raised to 6. So this gives us the value of escape velocity from earth, that is 11.2 kilometers per second. The spacecrafts which are sent to the moon or other planets have to have their initial velocity larger than the escape velocity so that they can overcome Earth's gravitational attraction and can travel to these objects. So the spacecrafts will have their initial velocity greater than 11.2 kilometers per second if they want to escape from the gravitational attraction of the Earth and travel to other planets or moon. So this is how we have calculated the escape velocity, and with this we have completed all the topics from the lesson, and we will end our session here only today. In the next session we will take up the question and answers and the numericals of the lesson. Thank you.